My name is Simon Buckley and I'm a Salford and Manchester-based artist. I work with photography, film, sound, music and text, and I've also introduced performance into my work over the past year too. Dark Days and Luminous Nights is a collaboration really between lots of different disciplines of work. There's music and performance, and I've contributed stills, and I've worked as a director on the film element to it. It's loosely a story, I suppose, but it's an ongoing story. It's about the journey of a city and how people exist within that city. We're exploring the places in which we exist within that city, and we're looking at transition and change and regeneration, and I think in these current times very relevantly looking at displacement and isolation too. So it's all of those things, and I think also involved is that element of the ghosts that sit within our city and within our souls. It's been one of those kind of interesting collisions of coincidence that happens in Manchester. We really sort of spoke originally in broad terms about what the Manchester Collective does with putting music into interesting spaces beyond concert halls, and that really chimed with me, who I believe that art, you know, should be made accessible, and I don't particularly exhibit in galleries. I like the idea of taking it almost into pubs and doing slideshows and things. You know, I think it's something that should be spread around. And so out of that evolved our collaborative sense of using the spaces that we have around us. And I had a particular interest in the River Irk Valley. I've been walking it a lot recently, and when he was talking about the nature of the music, and when I heard it, it seemed to fit very well with following the River Irk, which is an old and ancient river, which used to be beautiful countryside until industry took it and caused it to become a very much abused and neglected river. And there's a confluence with the River Irk, which again was the birthplace of Salford and really what helped Manchester become the city it's become. So it seemed to make sense with the White Hotel sort of sitting just across the road from the Irwell, that we looked at these two rivers coming together and followed their paths in, and kind of helped it looking at the way in which populations move into cities following rivers. And that's how it's developed really, is kind of that sense of exploration, and we've matched it with the music, which is obviously very beautiful and beautifully performed. So the film that we've made for Dark Days and Luminous Nights is in three sections to follow the music. We've nominally sort of followed three musicians who come from a community where they may have grown up, and they're displaced by the sense of perhaps the arriving regeneration of the area that I talked about. And so it's a loose narrative, you know, but it plays with these themes of regeneration and transition and isolation. And obviously, at the back of my mind, we've lived this incredible year during 2020, where we've all been in places of isolation. There has been displacement for a lot of us. We've all had to question our place within the city, I suppose. And art, to many extent, has been the thing that's got us through. Music has been important, but it's also something that we've lost. You know, we've lost live music, which is very important in the city of Manchester and Salford. So all these undercurrents and these sub-themes are at play there as well, without wanting to dwell too much on the ideas of COVID and stuff. But, you know, we have had those in the back of our minds. And, you know, you think about it through centuries, these same stories get repeated of displacement and isolation and regeneration. And so the stories are really a little bit about that, I think, and looking at these strange characters and how they survive this one journey through a night to away from their communities through isolation and into a space which they sense is sanctuary.